Friends, welcome back to my video series on structural analysis subjects. Now I thought let us not concentrate more on the structural analysis subjects and teaching you how to do the structural analysis subject or how to understand them properly. What I thought was, since it is a lockdown period, all of you will be at home, so you should have a skill of something called as a lifelong learning or a self-learning skills. So I have developed all these skills by using some of the software, some of the textbooks which are available, some of the e-notes which are already available in the internet. So what I thought was, like, instead of feeding you people, like instead of making a spoon feed to you people, let me equip you students to do the self-study at your home only, without the aid of any teacher. So what I will do is, I will put some videos which will tell you how to use some of the simple structural analysis softwares, some of the best YouTube channels to understand the structural analysis subjects, and many more, some of the good textbooks what you can refer, and some of the e-notes what you can refer. Now what I will do is, I will put some series of videos. So the first video what I will do today is, I will let you know one of the simple structural analysis software. This software is actually called as a STRAN, that is structural analysis. Now the specialty of this software is, like, you don't need to install this software, like you don't need to download this software on your desktop. You don't need to install that, of course. You have to have an internet, and if you have an internet, you can quickly open the web page of that software, and you can model your structure with the simple user-friendly graphics, and you can check or cross-check your answers with the manual calculations. This is just an aid for your manual calculations. I will not tell you, like, this only you have to refer. This software is useful only to cross-check your answers and to imagine the things, like how will be the deflected shape of the beam, where will be the maximum bending moment, how will the variation of bending moment, and all those things very quickly. So we'll quickly just check this software, right? Yes. Now this is the software, right? So this is called STRAN, that is structural analysis. You just need to type structural-analyzer.com. The link to this website, I will put it in a description. You can directly click on that. Now this is a simple GUI, that is a graphical user interface, what you can see here. This you can open on your desktop, that is internet. Also you can open this on your mobile also. It is a mobile friendly also. So you can see all these grids which are there. I will just give an introduction about how to use this software, or I should call it as a web page. Now the disadvantages and all those things I'll tell you later, but let me just quickly model one simple beam and one frame, and I will tell you how to analyze that. So whenever you move your cursor on this grid, you can see it snaps the grid points. So you have to click on any of the grid point. So let me just click here, okay, and when I do that, so you can see, you can hover your mouse. Okay, you can see that when you move your mouse on this grid, you can snap the grid points. Now let me just model one simple beam. Let me click on this grid and let me just model a beam of, say, around 10 meters, right? So you have to click on one of the grid, so drag that, and you can see here, just let me once again just show you that one. So I will just click here, I will drag my mouse, and you can see here dx refers to the length of the beam in x direction, and dy refers to the length of the beam in y direction. So I will just model my beam of 10 meters. So now you can see here 10 will appear here, right? Yes. Now I will click. Now I will just close this, so I can come out of that. Now your this beam is of a 10 meter. So these grids are 1 meters. Okay. Now I will just model my supports here. So I will take supports. You have to click on this supports tab, right? So you can see here types of supports: pinned, roller, roller vertical, fixed, and if you have a model that support by mistake, you can remove that. So what I will do, I will take a pinned support. I have to click on run it. So now you can pick, it is telling pick the nodes. I will pick this node and I will pick the middle node also. Let me pin this only, and I will click on fixed. Once again run it and I will click here. Now what problem it is facing is I can't model in between because I have created one beam of 10 meters. So if you want to have one more pin support here, you have to model your beam of 5 meter and then one more 5 meters. Then only you can get a node there. So then you can put a support at that point. Now my beam is of 10 meters, so I don't have intermediate node, so I can't put the node which I want, the support which I want at the middle directly. So no problem, let it be. So this is a pinned support and this is a fixed support. Now let me put some loads. So I will just cancel this one. So you can see here loads part. So you have to click on loads, right? Now you can see here what type of loads you can put. You can single, that is concentrated loads. Distributed also you can put, and you can remove any loads if you applied by mistake. Let me put one single concentrated load. So let that load be say 100 kilonewtons. I will not mention angle, so by default it will be 90 degrees. So I will run it. Now let me just, you can see here when I take my mouse, when I say here run, and when I take my mouse, it will tell you the coordinates. So that is 110, okay, and 990, that is from this point it is 90. So wherever I want, I can apply my load. So let me apply my load here, right? So it is 100 kilonewtons. Now I will also apply a distributed load of say 20 kilonewton per meter. I will just run it, and I want my 20 kilonewton per meter in the last 4 meters only. So what I have to do, I have to start from this point, that is 4 meters, 1, 2, 3, 4. I have to start from here, click here, take this and click here. It is means I have clicked the starting point and I have clicked the end point of the uniformly distributed load. Now let this be a beam. I will just close this. That's it. Your beam has been modeled. You have to just solve this. So you have to click on solve. Can you see here? You will quickly get the reactions. You can see pin, since the pin support, I have got only one reaction. Here I have got one reaction and one movement. So this is very quick thing to get the values. Now I can easily find out the shear force diagram and bending moment diagrams. So let me just click on diagrams. You can see here. So M refers to moment, V refers to shear, N refers to normal force, and D refers to deflection. So now my moment diagram is there. I will click on the moment diagram. My diagram is off, so let me on that one. You can see here. So on the load diagram and the reaction diagram only, you can see your moment diagram. Now suppose if you don't want to see the loads and if you don't want to see the reactions, you have to go to main, you have to off them. Means, so I don't want loads, off it. I also don't want reactions, off it. You can see here, this will be your bending moment diagram with the maximum bending moment values. So next I will go to moment tab. Once again I will off it. I will go to shear diagram and I will just on it, right? You can see this is the shear force diagram. Okay, now I will off that also. I will go to deflection diagram and just on that one. So this will be the deflected shape. Now if you take your mouse and at any point, you can see the value of deflection there. So the unit is in meters, so you can zoom that deflection diagram or whatever scale you want, you can zoom that one. So this is very easy thing to do. So this is the beam. Let me similarly model one frame also here. Let me just do that. Okay, now just deleted that part. Now I will model one simple frame. So let me start from this point, click here. Let my left column be of 5 meters length. Let my beam be say also of 6 meters. Let my another column be, that the right side column be of 3 meters. I'll just delete this one. So now I will go to supports, run it, fix here and fix here. close. I'll put my loads, go to loads. So let my concentrated load be of 100 and let this be of 90 degree. Okay, run it. I will apply here. You can see here. So if you put 90 degree, it will be in this direction. I will also put a distributed load of say 20 kN per meter only. Run it. Click from here up to here. That is start of the UDL up to the end of the UDL. Just close that. That's it. Solve. You can see here. You can see in the previous diagram I had on only the deflection shape. So you can see here. So if you want to see the reactions, go to diagrams, go to main tab. You can see reactions you have to on. You can see here. And let me off my loads and reactions, and also off my deflection. I want only my bending moment diagram. Yes, this will be your bending moment diagram. You can zoom that bending moment diagram at whatever scale you want. You can zoom that. I will off that. I will go to shear and I will on. So this will be your shear force diagram, right? Okay, now here you can also do something like, suppose if you have the column of some different moment of inertia, beam of some different moment of inertia, and this column of some different moment of inertia, then at that point of time, proportionate to the moment of inertia, you can change the area of cross-sectional area of these things. Like what you have to go do is, you have to go to sections, right? You have to specify what is the area in centimeter square and give some ID to that one. And also you can mention the moment of inertia and you can mention the modulus of elasticity, and you can give some ID to that and save it. Then you can once again go change the area, moment of inertia, and if you want to change the E also, you can change and you can modify the ID and you can give some different ID to that one. Once you do that, so you can just click here. If you go to sections, you have to choose which ID, that is whatever ID you will be giving here, that ID number will be coming here. So you have to choose that ID and you can apply to the selected one. Now I have not created anything, so let me just create that one. So let my cross-sectional area be 100, let my moment of inertia be 1000. I'm just taking an example, so 10,000. Let this be 200 gigapascal, right? I will give some ID to that, so let me give it as 1. Save the entity. So it has been created. So let me just close this. I will click here. I have already clicked. Go to sections, choose ID. So you can see here that created ID has come. So you have to select that one and apply to the selected. So section one, that is section one, this beam has been assigned with ID 1, which has cross section area of 100 centimeter square, moment of inertia of 10,000 centimeter raised to 4, and a modulus of elasticity of 200 gigapascal. Like this, you can create and you can model your structures. Now, the main disadvantage, I can't say it is a disadvantage, the only the shortcoming of this software is you can model only 2D structures. Only 2D structures you can model. No 3D structures are allowed, and I'm not sure how best you can model the trusses in that, because I have not seen any option. It might be there. If you can find that, please write it in a comment section. So I have not found where you can assign members which will carry only axial tension or axial compression, because trusses carry only that one. So that option I was unable to find that. If you can find, please let me know. I'm not expert in this. I have not created this software. So this software I just found while searching the internet. So you can also check the demo. You can check. You can also check the online tutorial, play tutorial, and you can check the creator's Facebook page where they have also created some of the other softwares also, which if you are interested, you can go through that one. So, but I found this is a very best software and one of the very quick software just to feel how the structure is behaving, how to get the reactions, what will be the bending moment diagram, shear force diagram, just to cross check with your manual calculations. This will be very much helpful to you students. So you can just go through this software. I will put the link of this software in the description for this video. You can check that. Thank you. I'll put some more videos on other topics also. So till that, stay tuned. Thank you. Bye.